guys, how are you?
Hey, Tatiana.
Good.
I have gotten to see like the first half or so of Dopesick so far, and I think it's really both heartbreaking and fascinating. Obviously, the opioid crisis is something that has affected so many lives. But Peter, what was it about Dopesick's approach specifically that made you want to jump on board?
I really like this sort of multifaceted approach where you're getting all these different angles on this narrative that kind of travels through them. I mean, it's wild. I mean, I have like one scene with Michael Keaton, and it's not like we're really even in the same world. We don't interact with each other like this is part of the story. It's just like he's on the stand and I'm sitting there. So I thought that that was a really excellent way of going about it while stitching this narrative through the middle of it. I had done this documentary in 2016 in Dayton, Ohio, where I went around interviewing different people from different aspects of the opioid crisis. And it was interesting, but there was no, you know, the spine was just the opioid crisis,
right,
in this place. And, you know, we had this fabulous writer who just managed to stitch together something that was so, it's like an octopus, you know, so wild the way he managed to connect all of these things, have them bounce off of each other. I just think he did such a tremendous job. So for me, it was really the way it was going to be told.
Yeah, definitely. John, you guys do have more time together because you were working on taking the fight to the companies, you know, together. Can you talk about Randy and Rick's like dedication to the cause, and what was it that really made them keep at it?
I think these guys are really fired up by a sense of right and wrong, and by a sense of their own community being sort of bullied by a big, huge company with more money than empathy. And they very different personalities who kind of balance each other really well. And that balance sort of keeps them focused, and they keep sort of coming back to the task at hand and pushing forward in pursuit of this goal. I love that they're so different from one another. I think it's fun to watch the two of them come at a problem from different angles and with different energies.
Definitely. Jake, I believe all three of you are based on real people. So what was it like for you to approach a character who is a real person that is among us today and part of this fight?
Right. Yeah, we've talked about this a bit, you know, that we had the luxury there that these aren't well-known people, you know, so they're not these iconic figureheads where you've got to like match a voice or match a look or match even like the mannerisms. So that makes it a little bit different. And then the benefit of having Danny Strong do all the investigative work, he's our showrunner and wrote all of this, was huge, because he did know all these people. He talked to these people all the time. He'd tell us about conversations he was having earlier that day with John Brownlee or Rick and Randy, and that like, oh, he told them, he told me this really cool thing is going to be in episode 7. So like, you know, you could almost trust his research to kind of paint the characters in the right light and then give you, just empower you with really great dialogue. I mean, that is one of the things I love about how complicated but still, you know, fun this job was. There's a lot of information. It's a serious topic, but like Rick and Randy's relationship, like they were saying, it's like that almost needs its own spinoff show. Like when I'd come in, I'd feel like it's the Odd Couple and I'm like their landlord. Like, you guys,
there is talk.
Staying on top of it, you know, various
talk. There is talk about a spinoff show, Rick and Randy.
So it still held space for it to be a, you know, levity and stuff like that.
That reminds me, there was one scene that I loved, the chicken pharma joke. I didn't get it at first.
Story.
I didn't understand until, and then I was like, oh my God, that's
I gotta tell you. We were very unprofessional that day. We almost couldn't make it through the scene.
Oh no.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, because once you hear it, in you and it's quaking around there, it's like church laughter.
Yeah.
And boy, Comey was just like, oh, go ahead, break.
Well, I'm proud of you guys for making it through for the cause. So thank you guys. You've done a great job. I cannot wait for everyone to see it and hopefully, you know, talk about it and continue the fight against Big Pharma in general.